We're trying to deviate away from thinking about robots as mechanical assemblies and rather considering them to be multifunctional material structures. In having that conceptual shift, it gives us access to all new materials and tools and technologies and ways of thinking about what a robot can be and what a robot can do. But it also throws out our general framework for what a robot could be and what a robot can do, which means answering the question, what is a robot, becomes challenging. I'm Rebecca Kramer-Bottiglio, and I'm a mechanical engineer and roboticist. So behind me is the amphibious robotic turtle. It features morphing limbs that morph between a flipper shape and a leg shape for efficient locomotion in water and on land, respectively. Aquatic locomotion and terrestrial locomotion are very different and use entirely different propulsion systems, right? So usually fins or flippers in water versus legs on land. Surveying water animals and land animals, we came across sea turtles and land tortoises, which are morphologically very similar, right? They're both quadrupeds. They both have this central carapace and hull. And they differ primarily in their limbs. So sea turtles have elongated, very flexible, flattened flippers that are optimized for swimming in water. Land tortoises have jointed, rounded, load-bearing legs that are optimized for walking on land. By focusing on these two animals as our inspiration, we could isolate the morphology change to just the limbs of the robot while keeping the central part of the robot completely the same. It has a kinematic chain in the shoulder joints, three servo motors that form a 3 degree of freedom shoulder joint. It has traditional batteries and power supply, electronics, controllers, all protected within the turtle shell. And then all of the soft robotic technology is in the limbs because that's what we're morphing. And so it uses coupled soft actuators and variable surface materials coupled along the length of the limbs in order to achieve that morphology change between a flipper shape and a leg shape, depending on whether the robot is in water or on land. If we have a robot that can efficiently locomote across multiple environments and can adapt to those different environments, you send out one platform. A robot that is more efficient can be out in the field longer, can collect more continuous streams of data in these environments that we are interested in monitoring. I don't think that there's one single answer to what is a soft robot. Soft robotic purists might answer that question saying that a soft robot is a robot that is made entirely of all soft materials. I think that many robots can be considered soft robots if they have some effective softness. We kind of decouple from thinking of a robot as a traditional, you know, machine made of rigid components and things that we associate with robots, you know, motors and metal, electronics, and we start to think of it more as a multifunctional material system. What can a robot be? What can a robot look like? What can a robot do? I think that's at the basis of soft robotics. There are no known animals in the world that are completely rigid. All animals are at least partially soft. So this is in contrast to the way that we typically design machines and robots. There might be a connection between the material composition and our animal capability to adapt to changing tasks and environments. Could soft robotic technologies and soft materials play a role in solving the adaptability problem for robots? So when you ask people to conjure up an image of a robot, typically people think of rigid machines that perform repeated tasks, robots that are on factory floors, and they're extremely good at what they're designed to do. These robots are fast and strong and precise, but they are not adaptable and they're not safe for human-robot interaction.
You douse me again and I'm not on fire, I'm donating you to City College.
And these are things that we need in order to deploy robots outside the factory floor in multi-environment settings, interacting with people in the real world. When we imagine robots for the future, we imagine something more like animals, like ourselves. We adapt our body properties, we adapt our stiffness. So I can change my muscle stiffness in order to perform both very gentle and very forceful tasks. We use soft materials for all of the basic robot components that you can think of. So if you think of a robot as made of sensors, actuators, controllers, and structures, We're making soft actuators, soft stretchable sensors that can accommodate the high strains of soft robots. And we are especially interested in variable stiffness materials, materials that can actively switch between rigid and soft phases. You know, soft robots don't need to necessarily be made of all soft materials, but rather robots in general can largely benefit from the inclusion of soft robotic technologies.